Hi, this is Billy Bean here with another segment of Truth by Billy Bean Special Report, episode 471, today's date, November 29, 2022. This is my third YouTube channel. I have a subscribe button in the lower right corner of my screen. Thanks for like, subscribe, and share on YouTube and Rumble. Some of my sources are God in the Bible, Patriot subscribers, Russell Bentley, David Nino Rodriguez, Dr. William Mount, New Atlas, Israeli News Live, Alex Cristoforo, Alexander Makaris, Tap Blog, Joshua Phillip, Steve Quayle's site, Hal Turner, a recent interview by Nicholas Veneman of Gene Decode, a recent interview by Underground Patriot of Dr. Jim Willie. Cliff High Plus. Now, some of the things we'll be covering. Russia preps war for all of Ukraine. Ukraine plus the deep state cyborgs. And FTX, a deep state crypto Ponzi. And as one source is pointing out, yeah, they named it Crypt. Toe, like crypt, a coffin. That was a giveaway. So we got that going on. Now we'll talk about the FTX deep state Ponzi scheme and what that means and how it's affecting other crypto companies right now. We had Congress, the so-called Congress, send to Ukraine about $100 billion, and then it was invested in the FTX crypto, and then it came back to course all the Ukraine government individuals to be paid off, the deep state. Then it also came back to the Dems and the Rhino Republicans for their November 8 event. Takes a lot of money to do certain things. And so then on November 10, Sam Bankman-Fried, the CEO, resigned and declared bankruptcy. And oh, like the next weekend, he was in New York City addressing bankers along with Zelensky, talking about how to handle money because the FTX was a deep state scheme to Ponzi scheme to take down crypto and then bring on a digital money system, which the deep state is currently testing their computers. And Dr. William Mount said a launch date for the deep state to take all the money of US citizens and set them up with only digital bank accounts is July 1, 2023. I don't think that's going to come to fruition. I don't think the American people are going to tolerate that because we understand several characteristics of a free people. One, they're armed. They have rights to defend themselves. And number two, another characteristic of a free people, they have a currency system flowing through their society. Now, they certainly can have, and banking should be founded on gold or silver or oil, tangible assets. But there still needs to be a currency system flowing freely through a society, not one that's controlled by your government digitally. And the digital banking system is all what goes along with a social scoring system. We, the government, oh, you spoke out against the government. We'll cut you off from any credits or money in your bank account. No, Can't be. Now, This FTX going down also brought down Genesis, that had about $750 million invested in FTX. So that's going to declare bankruptcy. Now, BlockFi is also going to declare bankruptcy, and did declare bankruptcy on November 28. It had liabilities of 1 to 10 billion and assets of 265 million. So it was also tied to FTX. So far, the deep state's winning, aren't they? So everyone who's invested in crypto, I don't know how you're going to get your money back. Now, this is coming out that Gazprom, this is the Russian company that sells oil and gas, and they're taking down all of the Nord Stream pipelines. They're shutting them all down. So there's no natural gas or oil going to be flowing, certainly to Germany or other parts of Europe, and it could be other nations too. So that's being shut down right now. Now, Alexander Christofaros talking about EU is going to freeze. And we understand that was from Steve Quayle, that this winter is going to be a 1 in a 500-year winter. Okay. And that the U.S. money is going down along with the weapons stockpile. Yeah. Some are saying that the U.S. cannot defend itself, but I think that's only 30% of the shadow U.S. military that's aligned with the shadow U.S. government. Now, that's 30%. The other 70% of the U.S. military has, I'm sure, plenty of missiles tucked away to defend the United States of America. Okay, Tap Blog is bringing this out, that England is sending to Ukraine laser-guided Brimstone 2 missiles, and they can be used mobily on a truck or from a plane, and they're also sending $60 million to Ukraine. Now, we understand that when a government sends all this money into Ukraine, it's being laundered somehow. And the nation that sent it, their politicians get money. The government individuals inside Ukraine get money. Then it goes back, you know, it's distributed to everyone. The shadow U.S. government, military, NATO. Yeah, everybody gets a piece of it. It's not intended for Ukraine and the Ukraine people. Okay. We had this. Polish officers were given an order. This is, I'll draw you a map. This is Luhansk, Donetsk, Zaporizhzhia, Kherson, about here, Bakhmut, which is apparently an important logistical location, apparently. So Polish officers who were fighting with the Ukraine military were given orders to do something, go on the front line here, and the Polish officers said no, that would be suicide, whatever the situation was, because we know that Russia has, you know, missiles that they send and other things. So then the Azov group, which is a paramilitary group inside Ukraine, founded, trained, and funded by the shadow U.S. government, actively follows the philosophy of Germany of World War II. You know, the N philosophy. So then, the Polish officers refused. The Azov were going to assassinate them, but the Polish officers got the upper hand and assassinated the Azov assassination group. So that happened about November 25 or 26. Now we wonder, are these Polish troops still going to be fighting with this Ukraine military? Are they going to see writing on the wall? We don't know. All right. So now, we have new reports coming out about various things. Okay, Israeli News Live, Stephen Bannon, formerly with the CIA, now has the ministry, regularly gets updates from the Pentagon, talking about Azov. In the past, when they had captured Russian POWs, they castrated them and then murdered them. And then now there's an effort being made to complain to the UN, or it is the UN who is taking this up to investigate the recent murder of 11 POWs, Russian, by the Ukraine military are the Azov group, and they videotaped it and released the videotapes. So it's all over the internet, and you see the Russian POWs face down on the ground, unarmed. They were all shot in the back of the head. So that's going on. And the individuals who did it are bragging about it and releasing the video. So, yeah. What can we say about the Ukraine military, founded, funded, and trained by the shadow NATO? What can we say? All right, now this is coming out. Jean Decaud was recently interviewed by Nicholas Veneman. He's out of England and is talking about in Ukraine. What's going on is, so in Ukraine, we have Luhansk, Donetsk, Zaporizhzhia, Kherson. They had, initially, when Russia went in, according to Russell Bentley, he's a Texan who's now a citizen of Donetsk, Russian citizen. That and he had fought with the military there. One of the things that happened when Russia first went in, which was February of 2022, near Kiev, they took out a plane that had a broken arrow that would be a lost nuke. And so Russia took that out. And we understand from Dr. William Mount that the FBI took in 24 baseball-sized nukes, first in Warsaw, Poland, in the summer. Then they went to Kiev, and 24. Russia bought 22 of them at $2 million each. One was destroyed. One is in play. But at the beginning, February of 2022, Russia took out the plane that had a broken arrow, a lost nuke in it. And they also took out some deep underground areas that had 12,000 cyborgs in them. And you ask, what is a cyborg? That's a human that has been memory wiped. And this is off-world technology, but it's used by certain shadow human groups on the earth who have. Who do not worship God for sure. And then they wipe the humans' brains because they don't want the humans having any contact with God. And then they implant them with different implants, do genetic experiments on them so they run faster and all of this. Some of these can also be brought in from off-world by certain groups, and the deep state is deeply into this. All right, so cyborgs, hybrids. Now we know the Bible, we can relate to this. The fallen angels, Genesis 6, and they mated with humans. They made the Nephilim, which are hybrids. And so that's going on. So at any rate, there were 12,000 cyborgs in one of these deep underground areas, according to Gene Code, when the Russians came in and they were able to, and the Russians employed electromagnetic pulses underground, and this shorted out the cyborgs that require electricity to operate. So, and now what's happening is these cyborgs, and for sure the hybrids, are not connected to God. And they get their energy by consuming or using energy output from humans. And now they've been cut off from one source called the Red Drink. And so they can no longer shapeshift. And this would be the hybrids, also off-world entities allegedly are here coming in through portals. Brought in by witchcraft practiced by the deep state. So, but they're cut off from this energy source and from other and from consuming humans. And so they can no longer shapeshift. And so they're being seen on the ground. And so Russia and other nations, I'll bring this information out to you. Because we know in the Bible it's said, we wrestle not against flesh and blood. And so that's going on. Now, we have this. We have NATO then, the shadow NATO. Yes, they want nations around the world. Send us your sons and daughters to be slaughtered for the shadow NATO agenda. So NATO had a meeting of 30 nations, 11, 29, and it's going to be on Tuesday and Wednesday. So I guess it's today and tomorrow. And it's in Romania. And it's discussing different things. Now I'll show you what they've done so far. So we have Ukraine, we have Belarus, we have Estonia, Latvia, Lithuania. Now, Kaliningrad is a Russian enclave. Then in this area, we know we have Finland, we have Sweden, we have Norway. Now, we have here Ukraine. So we've got Poland, Slovakia, Hungary, Bulgaria, Romania. All right. So now, NATO had already pre-positioned troops in these areas in Estonia, Latvia, and Lithuania. They put these battle groups in 2017. And these groups are about 900 to about 1300 each. And now they want to put them into these areas. Now we know recently we heard in Romania we've got the 101st, that's about 4,700 US. And in Poland we have, according to a retired Army Colonel Douglas MacGregor, 40,000 US. And then Romania, I think they had 40, 30, 20,000 troops here of Romania, 40,000 US, 30,000 Polish, and these are Romanian. Now, NATO wants to build up these groups and bring in additional NATO troops from where? We ask. Now, this 40,000 US is in addition to the 10,000 US that was there at the beginning, according to Dr. William Mount, who were went in as advisors. So we understand then that NATO wants to increase the number of troops that it has. And we get this, that yeah, they want to increase them to brigade size, which is 5,000. So I'd be curious what nations are going to be sending their troops there. Poland rejects having Patriot missiles in Poland from Germany. They want Germany to send them directly to Ukraine. And we understand French troops are inside Bulgaria training in Transylvania, Romania. Spain is going to temporarily loan Ukraine 8 F-18 fighters. And in Romania, the US maintains the air shield. So that's going on. Now, we have this, that Russia currently, this is now November 2022, all over Ukraine. They have increased their bombing and they are cutting electricity, water, and plus other things, communications, rail, roads. And it's important to remember that these cyborgs and these off-world entities and other soldiers, troops need electricity to operate certain missiles and weapons. So they're taking out the electricity. Now, we understand that's what is going to happen in December when the ground freezes solid so that tanks can roll. And the numbers we're getting is Russia is building up 500 to 750,000. These are Russian troops plus troops from China, North Korea, Iran, South Arabia, the Czech Republic, and other areas. So that's going on. Now, Hal Turner is coming out with this information that Russia is going to be using thermobaric bombs. And these go in, and they're very similar to a nuclear explosion, except you don't have the radiation residue fallout. But what they do, they explode, they pull all of the air out of the atmosphere. Anything that breathes oxygen dies. So they're going to be doing a 500 kilogram. I know when I first looked at this, I thought, you've got to be kidding me. But no, it's gram, which is actually 0.0005 kiloton. So not to be confused. But at any rate, the kill rate would be similar to a nuke this size because it draws the air, the oxygen out of the air. So they're called Fab 500. The US military calls them MOAB, MOAB. So that's going on. Now, I have to say this, that recently on Channel 2, that's a TV channel out of Houston, on November 26, I actually heard myself an emergency, a broadcast practice. I thought, wow, I wonder what this means. Now, David Nino Rodriguez had a great interview recently with a man who had gone to hell. So, a lot of this war rhetoric, I think it's good for people to be preparing their souls, possibly to meet, God. Okay, a prayer. This is the second of 12 prayers in the Mulberry Bush series. And the Mulberry Bush, David and 2 Samuel was going to battle and asked God about it. God said, wait by the mulberry trees. Wait till you hear a certain sound, and then you can go to battle, because I, God, and my angel armies, we're going to go before you. So this prayer is based on that concept, and it's from the New Life Translation, and it's entitled Marching Feet. Father, we know when the children of Israel left Egypt, they were frightened by the sound of the marching feet of the Egyptians, who were chasing them to enslave them again. Now we, your sons and daughters, face fallen angels plus, who seek to maintain their slave hold on us by our governments, our economic systems, our educational systems. Plus, we say, Father, let us, as David and his army, hear marching feet in the trees, and when we go behind the tree, circle back behind the enemy. And this will be a signal to us to attack, as we are guaranteed victory. With you, our commander God, and your angel armies going before us. And we say, bring it, Father. And we thank you, Father, Son, Jesus, whom many call Yeshua, and the Holy Spirit. I say to my family and friends, remain steady out there. Continue to pray. God is in charge, and He is on the move. I love you, and I'll see you soon.